So one thing that tends to bother new people who are trying to learn Altium Designer is the copy and paste in the PCB library and in the PCB layout editors. And the reason it's kind of a bother or a frustration is because during a copy, Altium Designer is looking for a point of reference. And this is actually a very powerful feature, but for someone who's just used to just selecting something and copying it and then pasting it afterwards, this may throw them off a bit because of the muscle memory that they contain. So let's take a look at this a little closer. What happens is that when we select something and do a Control C, or if we happen to go to the menu and click copy here, you'll notice that it's actually waiting for another point of information. As a matter of fact, if you look at the very bottom, it says select a reference point. And we miss this all too often, again, because of muscle memory. And what can even happen is that once we've done a Control C, maybe we move along, and depending on how fast you are or how quickly you zoom out, you may start panning and you may hit the left mouse button. And the left mouse button is an enter key as opposed to a right mouse button, which would cancel it. So now we effectively have a large distance between where this component is and where my cursor is, and that is now the point of reference. What used to happen, and still happens, but it was even worse in older versions of Altium Designer, is if I did a Control V, you'll notice that you don't see the component. So let me do another right click here, and this is again what people would do is they'd use the right mouse button, not realizing that they put this here way off to the left side. In older versions of Altium Designer, that was a problem because you couldn't see quadrant 2, you couldn't see quadrant 3, and you couldn't see quadrant 4. And that would cause a lot of problems. As a matter of fact, in order to get these components, once you detected them, and they were usually detected by some type of DRC, what you would have to do is go into the panels, and you would select your PCB list panel here, and you would check out the X and Y coordinates and see which ones had these negative values in there, and then you could change those and they would appear back in quadrant 1 so you could delete them. Fortunately, with the newer versions of Altium Designer, and I think this is primarily because of their 3D capabilities, it's pretty easy to see these things now and to simply delete them. So what's the purpose of this thing? Well, really the purpose of it is to ensure that you have a point of reference, especially when you're copying and pasting things from one place to another. So just to give an example, if I select this poly and I do a Control X, I again get the green cursor here. It's a prompt saying, well, give me a reference point. So I'm going to use this mounting hole. So I'm going to click here. Now notice if I do a Control V where my cursor is, it's really easy for me to bring this back because I know exactly where the reference point is. And boom, I'm done. And it's perfectly lined up as it was before. So that's really the power of this copy with reference. And if you actually find it to be very, very useful, you can actually use it on the schematic side as well. So let's take a look at that. By default, the schematic does not use this type of copy with reference. You have to turn it on. So how do we do that? We go into the preferences. So we'll go to the cog here. Make sure that you're in schematic, graphical editing. Make sure you turn on the clipboard reference. This is not turned on by default. And I would also encourage you to turn off the object's electrical hotspot because this will override whatever clipboard reference that you have. And that's especially true possibly with components which do have electrical hotspots and of course with net labels as well. So if you want to have full control over that, then you'll want to definitely use the clipboard reference with this turned off, the object electrical hotspot. So let's press OK and let's just demonstrate this. And it really doesn't matter what object you select. At this point, I could even do it on a power port. So I'm going to do Control C. Now you do again see the large cursor. It's not in green, but you have the prompt at the bottom saying, where do you want the clipboard location? And just to demonstrate this, I'll move it quite a bit away here and I'll press down on my left mouse button. The copy is now complete. So let's zoom out to another part of the schematic and let's do a Control V. And you can see that the cursor is that the paste retained the reference to where I had selected. So I hope that you found this useful and appreciate your time. May it make you a little more efficient in Altium Designer. And we encourage you to look at the other videos on this channel.